white bread and white egg.
So I'm going to talk about bread first, just briefly, because I am from Taiwan, and in Chinese culture, red is considered lucky or well-blessed color. So for Chinese New Year, wedding, and then any festivals, we always have to have something with red. And so that's why, I'm surprised myself. When I was back in Taiwan, I didn't think about red at all. The longer I left Taiwan, the more often I use red. And then you ask me why, I don't have answer for that. Now we go to the ants. Of course, like a lot, most of the children, I played with ants when I was little. But I killed them. I used the magnifying glass to focus the sunlight to burn them. And then, when I was little, my father planted 4 or 3 trees in front of a house, and then he assigned us a job after school. We had to water them. And you know, ants, in town, there are so many species, especially the red one. Oh, the plant was super herb. So when I had to water them, I would go this way. Because they didn't grow. And then in early 90s, I used sugar in my backyard to draw a human figure, the outline of human. And I was hoping the ants will come to join me and draw a black line. They didn't. So I sort of, when I was working on also the project, so I put it away. But it comes back. It's like my other project ideas. When it's interesting, they keep on coming, knocking on my brain, say, hey, when are you to do with this? So 2006, I spent a month in Hungary. And most of the time, I was outside using my video camera and camera to photograph or videotape ants. And that time, I actually had a quite clear idea about how I was going to do ants. I was going to draw a lip on the glass and have ants crawl on the glass with honey and with a traffic background. But they did like glass. They did instantly. So I had to compromise. So 2009, before I was invited to Japan for a residency and show, I finished this piece, Kiss You Honey, and it was shot nearby in the garage here, nearby the garbage can. But before that, I also had to tell you some kind of background. Ants like to wander around in my kitchen and then the dining area, and I used to I use this chalk. It's plastic, it's called deadline. And they import it from China. And you make a line there, it's a deadline. Once they touch the deadline, and they are dead. But at one point, I said to myself, I'm not going to kill anything alive. So I use fly to make one piece. So I don't even kill fly. Anyway, I stopped killing anything alive. So I talk to them, I say, wonder in my living area, but one of these days let's work on a project together. I don't know if they understand that or not. Anyway, when the idea is ready, so I start shooting this Kiss You Honey in the garage nearby the garbage area. From working on the project, I also learned a lot about ants. When I first put out honey, oh, they're going crazy. They all stay on each other and finish it. Oh, I say, well, this piece is easy. No, it's not as I expected. They are amazing. They are very young women. They're very picky about food. If you feed them honey in 3 days in a row, they are tired. They don't want to touch the honey anymore. And I say, my dear, I'm coming. I am leaving for Japan. Where are you? Come back, come back. But at the same time, I was sun-dried this fish organ that was saved by my family from Taiwan. It's the most delicious food in the whole world. I grew up eating it when I was little, but I forget about it. After I moved to this country a few years ago, I had a chance to taste it again. I said, oh my God, I forget about it. So my family kept on sending me need it, but you have some dry. So that time when they sent it to me, it was not quite dry, so I put it off. Now I found ants, they love it. They really knew what is good. So I say, okay. So I put this rich organ at one end and then draw these lips. So they all love the fish organ first. And on their way home, I have a little taste of the honey. So it's their dessert. And from there I learned. You know, the ants, they all love sweet, actually love fish. So when I went out the fish organ, I would feed them chicken or fish instead of that. And then still, they never get tired of it. So when I was ready to shoot ants in the city, I kept them in the dining area, but I had to go to Ireland for a show. So, you know, I had to have my friend coming to babysit the ants. Because I could prepare the food, my friend would come in and then put out the food. And you know what? They like fresh meat. When you have the 1 day old and the fresh meat there, they go to the fresh meat. And then toward the end, when I was about to come back, I received this email from this young friend, said, "Dear auntie, I'm so sorry, all the ants are gone." I said, "Don't worry, I'll get them back. Can I come back?" "Yes, I know how to get them back." I said, "Hey, you guys, you already got ready to work and you have to come back." So they did come back. And then because for the kissing honey, I went 2.5 hours. And I have all the friends here who help me have different stages, this and the way. And then. So I thought, and I wanted to shoot it at night when it comes to the light. So I said, "Wait, 6 hours I can go." No, I was amazed again. Their supervisor sent out the ants, depends on the job. So at the end you will see the ants there. So I thought they should be able to finish in an hour. No, it took me 38 hours to wait for they clean up the whole thing.